You're watching ESPN's Holiday Hoops, presented by Kay Jewelers.
It's another beautiful December day in Waikiki Beach. We're in Honolulu for the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic. As fourth-ranked Arizona and outstanding guard Mark Lyons take on East Tennessee State and stud freshman Lester Wilson. Number four, Arizona, East Tennessee State. The Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic next. Happy holidays from Honolulu and welcome to the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic, all part of Holiday Hoops, presented by K Jewelers. Tonight, it's fourth-ranked Arizona and East Tennessee State quarterfinal action of the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic. Take a look at the brackets for the tournament. Earlier today, Indiana State outlasts Ole Miss in overtime. A big win for the Sycamores. And 18th-ranked San Diego State rolls past Rex Walters and the USF Dons. Along with the most outstanding player from the 1997 Final Four, Miles Simon. Roxy Bernstein with you. Number four, Arizona, East Tennessee State. And Miles, Arizona, one of five teams remaining unbeaten in the country. Are they one of the elites in college basketball?
Well, Rocky, their record says they are. They beat a top five team in the Florida Gators a week ago in Tucson on a last second shot. But I believe that their best basketball is still ahead of them because they have a young freshman front line in Ashley, Jared, and Tarzewski that's going to continue to get better. And by the middle of February, watch out for the Wildcats.
Well, take us to our one-on-one for this matchup. What are you looking for with Arizona and East Tennessee State?
Well, first for Arizona, Nick Johnson has just made a huge leap in his game from his freshman to sophomore season. He's shooting the three-point shot at a higher percentage. He leads the team in assists. He's great in transition. He's an excellent complement to senior point guard Mark Lyons at the two-guard spot, and he's leading the Wildcats in assists and steals. And then for East Tennessee State, it's all about Lester Wilson. He scores the ball at a high level, loves to shoot the three-point shot. He's a big, physical guard with huge shoulders, can penetrate, guard multiple positions. Wildcats will have to keep an eye on him tonight and keep him out of the mix.
Arizona Wildcats, the starting five for the 9-0 Arizona Wildcats. Mark Lyons, a senior point guard, playing in this Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic for the second consecutive season. He came here with Xavier last season, now a senior in Tucson. For East Tennessee State, and they're going to rely on their freshmen. It's been a turbulent season so far for the 2-7 Buccaneers. But Lester Wilson, John Walton need to come through tonight for East Tennessee State. Murray Bartow, the head coach of the Buccaneers, in his 10th year at East Tennessee State, the son of the legendary Gene Bartow. He and his dad, the late Gene Bartow, have combined for 931 wins, which is fourth most in the father-son combination as far as coaches go in college basketball. Sean Miller on the other side in his fourth season at Arizona after 5 years at Xavier. 30-win season a couple of years ago for Sean Miller and an Elite Eight performance for the 9-0 Arizona Wildcats. Arizona wearing the red, the home whites for East Tennessee State. This neutral site game in Honolulu were underway. Arizona and East Tennessee State quarterfinals of the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic.
And East Tennessee State starting out in man-to-man defense, but you'll see a lot of zone from them today, something Arizona has struggled with during the season.
Here's Brandon Ashley with the perimeter jumper, knocked down by the freshman from San Francisco.
And that's about Brandon Ashley's range, 17 to 18 feet. Nice skip pass across the court. Excellent catch and shoot by the freshman.
East Tennessee State, it's been a rough go of it so far for the Buccaneers coming in at 2-7. They've lost their last four.
Well, really a depleted roster for East Tennessee State. Lester Wilson leading scorer at 18 points a game. But their team that came in with four seniors to start the season, now they're only down to one because of dismissals and injuries.
Here's the seven-footer, Caleb Tarzewski. Freshman goes outside, Solomon Hill drives the lane. Kept alive by Brandon Ashley. And a loose ball corralled by East Tennessee State and John Walton, the freshman from Memphis.
Arizona with a distinct height advantage on the inside with Ashley and Tarzewski, and they'll bring in Troll and Grant Jarrett off the bench. East Tennessee State's tallest player, only going 6'8".
Shot clock at 12. Here's Jarvis Jones, a senior trying to create here for the Buccaneers. Three on the shot clock. Desperation three. And the rebound cleared by Nick Johnson. Here comes Arizona. Mark Lyons missing a three in transition. Solomon Hill runs down the rebound. Arizona 9-0, their best start since 1987-88 when they started the year 12-0, and they went to the Final Four. As Brandon Ashley misses, but cleaned up by Caleb Tarczewski. He was fouled. He'll go to the free throw line for the and one free throw.
And I love the aggressive mentality of Brandon Ashley. Can't finish on the first attempt, but Tarczewski, the 7-footer, able to put it back and draw the contact going to the line to finish the three-point play.
John Walton called for the foul of East Tennessee State. First whistled against either side, and Arizona up 4-0.
Tarczewski standing 7 feet, part of the number three ranked recruiting class in the country that Sean Miller brought in, along with Gabe York, Brandon Ashley, and Grant Jarrett. This can be the type of game where Caleb Tarczewski, only averaging 6 points a game on the year, they can get him a lot of post touches, make him feel comfortable on the inside.
Threes, an air ball from the corner by Lester Wilson, and Arizona clears. Here's a touch to Tarczewski.
He needs to be aggressive here. They're leaving him one-on-one in the post.
And he banks it in, and it's 6-0 Arizona.
And I like the setup by Tarczewski. He faked the pass fake because he had skipped it out the time before. Takes his time, two back down dribbles, and a beautiful turnaround jump hook off the glass.
30-second timeout taken by East Tennessee State as Arizona off to a good start. They're going inside to their freshman.
Sean Miller, great at player development. Look at the face up. He skips, fakes the skip pass, takes his time, backs down. The smaller Hunter Harris, standing only 6'6", and giving up nearly 50 pounds to the center, Caleb Tarczewski. Great touch by the freshman from Claremont, New Hampshire.
The Arizona Wildcats 9-0, one of five remaining teams in college basketball without a loss. One of the better shooting teams in college basketball. And Nick Johnson really excelling for the Wildcats in his sophomore season, the Gilbert, Arizona product. Last year, Pac-12 all-freshman team selection. And Arizona, the last time they were 9-0, you got to go back to the 87-88 season when Steve Kerr, Sean Elliott, Tom Tolbert, Anthony Cook, Craig McMillan. How about that starting
group? Well, what a great team. And then here's the pressure. Great job by Nick Johnson, who's averaging 4 steals a game over his last four. Gets his hand on that basketball, creating the turnover and finding his backcourt partner, Mark Lyons, for the finish. But yes, that 87-88 team, one of the best in Arizona history. Go to the Final Four. Steve Kerr, a bunch of pros on that team. Sean Elliott ended up being a National Player of the Year, has his jersey retired in the Kale Center.
And Caleb Tarczewski picks up the loose ball. Arizona looks to push. Brandon Ashley attacks down the lane. Block, count it, and one. Brandon Ashley makes it 10-0 Arizona.
Two great things about that play. As we go back to the steal off the full court pressure, East Tennessee State lacking in backcourt depth with great anticipation by Nick Johnson. But on this fast break play, the outlet by Mark Lyons, who's really learning how to play the point guard position this year, never played it at Xavier, but finding Solomon Hill, and Solomon Hill with the unselfish dish to Brandon Ashley.
So number four Arizona has scored the first 11 points of this game. East Tennessee State desperately looking to get on the scoreboard here. Jarvis Jones, the pull up, and it gets the Buccaneers into the scoring column.
Jarvis Jones, a guy who can really fill it up. This is only his third game of the season. He was out because of ineligibility due to academic reasons. The only senior currently on the roster.
Brandon Ashley already with 7. Comes in averaging 9 a game.
Well, excellent interior pass from Nick Johnson to Brandon Ashley against that zone defense.
Loose ball tipped out of bounds by Arizona. Good hustle from Mark Lyons, the senior. It's out of bounds to East Tennessee State. 13-2 start for the Arizona Wildcats. And let's face it, you look at these two teams, Mild, and East Tennessee State, frankly, overmatched on talent. They put in a lot of effort, but this is a very difficult matchup for them going up against the number four team in the country.
Yeah, they're a little bit overmatched. They only have nine guys that can suit up for practice right now that are healthy bodies. Actually, Coach Bardo's son is suiting up. Alec, he's a manager to make 10 so they could go 5-on-5 yesterday. But if you're Sean Miller, in a game like this against a team that you probably should beat, you love to see your team come out with aggressiveness, not playing flat after long travel days by many of the teams, 7 of the 8 teams that come over to the Diamond Head Classic. But Arizona coming out with a lot of energy and effort in the first 4 minutes.
Well, here's what happened earlier today here at the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic. Jake Odom and Indiana State in overtime knock off Ole Miss, who've been playing very well coming into this tournament.
Manny Arak, the Gonzaga transfer, having a huge game. And then San Diego State, Chase Tapley, puts up a career-high 33 points for the Aztecs as they were able to...
Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic, welcome aboard along with Miles Simon, Roxy Bernstein with you. Glad you're with us. We're in Honolulu, really happy to be here for the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic. Quarterfinal action here as Arizona off to a hot start against East Tennessee State. 13-2, the Wildcats out in front trying to advance to the quarterfinals along with Indiana State and San Diego State. And Miles, what have you seen so far from Arizona here in this matchup with East Tennessee State?
Well, Arizona's really taken advantage of their depth. They've come out with a lot of energy and effort in the first 4 minutes of this game. They've pressed a little, got turnovers. Brandon Ashley has been super active, 9 points early in this ballgame.
Well, Brandon Ashley and Caleb Tarzewski getting involved as Arizona going inside, relying on that very talented freshman class. As already going into his bench, Sean Miller bringing in another outstanding freshman. Grant Jarrett checks into the game. And Grant Jarrett, 6'10" from La Vergne, California. And also their super sub sixth man, Kevin Parham, enters the ballgame as senior from the Bronx. East Tennessee State needs to find some way to get into some kind of a flow offensively. Arizona's done a nice job of disrupting their rhythm here early.
And for East Tennessee State, that guy has to be Lester Wilson, number 15, 6'4" shooting guard, averaging 18 points a game.
Fouled and count the basket for John Walton. And there was the East Tennessee State talented freshman, Walton, who gets the and one.
John Walton, great job of up faking, driving, drawing the contact. Brandon Ashley just tried to wall up there and stay big. Walton with the excellent finish.
First foul on Brandon Ashley. Free throw rolls in somehow for John Walton after it deadens off the backboard in the heel of the rim. To the other end, Arizona beats East Tennessee State down the floor to lay in for Grant Jarrett.
And Coach Murray Bardo can't be happy about that. You get the basket and finish on the other end, and they're going to beat you down the court in two passes. Nice job by the Arizona Wildcats.
And there is an errant pass and a giveaway from Jarvis Jones in East Tennessee State with a turnover. As the Wildcats lead it by 10, we're not even 5 minutes in. Arizona, one of 5 remaining unbeatens in college basketball after 3 go down today.
Duke played one of the toughest schedules in the country so far. Cincinnati was my sleeper team in the preseason. They're proving me to be right now. And then Wyoming, in a tough Mountain West, staying undefeated, have a great win over Colorado at home.
Solomon Hill hits a 3.
Excellent inside-out action by the Arizona Wildcats. The 3-point shot, probably the biggest improvement in Solomon Hill's game over his career as a Wildcat.
The block by Grant Jarrett. Mark Lyons racing out. Foul. Offensive foul, a charge on Mark Lyons in Arizona.
Well, great baseline to baseline action here on this last play. As Walton, you know you have to go up strong. But Grant Jarrett waiting there, blocking it with his left hand, and then Mark Lyons trying to get out in transition. Jones might have still been sliding on that play, but the officials saw it differently.
So the offensive foul, second team foul on Arizona. Wildcats by 13. Switch, Lester Wilson hits the three, and the pick and pop was there for East Tennessee State.
That was a defensive breakdown by Arizona there. Solomon Hill called out the switch plenty early. Mark Lyons not able to recover to Lester Wilson on that switch.
Mark Lyons rattles in the three. And he stepped a good 3 feet behind the line.
Yeah, but a great answer there by Lyons. A guy who was suspended last year at Xavier for that brawl against Cincinnati, was really redeeming himself here as an Arizona Wildcat. Hits that game winner a week ago against the University of Florida, as Florida was a top five team at the time.
There's a steal again, Mark Lyons. One-on-one to the basket. Shot won't spin in, the rebound cleared Lester Wilson and the Buccaneers. Kennard Gadsden-Gilliard into the key. And the rebound cleared Solomon Hill. Seems like Xavier's really, or rather East Tennessee State is really struggling with Arizona's pressure.
Well, Arizona has so much more size and athleticism. Man-to-man defense. And there now they're just picking apart that zone. Great passing, great interior passing by the Wildcats. And another finish right around the rim for Arizona as they go up 15.
Largest lead for the Wildcats, and East Tennessee State uses their second timeout already of this first half.
And in that high post area, Kevin Parham, that's an adjustment that Coach Sean Miller has made in two earlier games this season when they faced zone defenses of Southern Miss and College of Charleston, one where they had 27 turnovers against Southern Miss. They decided to put Kevin Parham in the high post area because he's a great facilitator. The tendency for Parham, if he's on the perimeter against the zone, is just to become a stagnant three-point shooter, a catch-and-shoot guy, not as active. But there, now he's in the high post, 15 to 17 feet, where he can shoot, pass, excellent bounce pass there, as Ashley was ghosting on the baseline and then the finish.
Arizona, look at the balanced scoring for the Wildcats this season. Mark Lyons leading score at under 14 points a game. But all the starters, for the most part, have been consistent up around 10, other than Caleb Tarzewski, but off the bench, Kevin Parham, providing a nice spark. Here's the runner. And the rebound cleared by Arizona.
Here now you'll see the adjustment again. Grant Jarrett, who's actually the power forward with this lineup on the floor, going to the perimeter because he's an excellent three-point shooter, and they love to use Parham on the inside.
There it is, but they wave it off on a three-second call and a turnover by the Wildcats.
And they actually got what they wanted, just Parham hanging around in the key a little bit too long after he made the pass.
Sean Miller's team up by 15 here in the first half against East Tennessee State. What do the Buccaneers need to do to try to get something going here in this end of the floor offensive?
Well, it's going to need to be Jarvis Jones and Lester Wilson. Those are their two main scorers, most experienced guys. Have to get them touches. Need to try to get something attacking the rim, getting layups or kickouts for threes.
Jarvis Jones from deep. And the rebound going high up to get it is Grant Jarrett. Inside to Kevin Parham. Nick Johnson spots up for a three. And the rebound, Angelo Chole missing the putback, and Hunter Harris the rebound for East Tennessee State.
Well, a great job by Chole getting inside position against the zone, but he kind of faded away on the layup, just needs to take it up strong and finish.
Ball poked away. Here goes Nick Johnson. Showtime!
Wow. Hashtag SC top 10 right there. 360 on his birthday for Nick Johnson.
He said happy birthday to himself right there. That was pretty from Nick Johnson. Nick Johnson, the son of Joey Jumpin' Johnson.
Nick Johnson getting busy in the air right here with the 360 slam, putting the Wildcats up 17.
uptown called Russellville.
Yes.
Go down 940. Go around the 40 span, right in the middle. Not Arkansas. I saw that ball hit him right there. Good thing he's hurt, got a cane, I throw it at him.
ESPNU's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Hawaiian Airlines. Hawaii flies with us. ESPNU's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Hawaiian Airlines. Hawaii flies with us.
Waikiki Beach. Look down at yonder is Diamond Head. We're at the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic, where fourth-ranked Arizona out to a great start, leading East Tennessee State 25-8. 11:08 to go first half of this quarterfinal matchup, and Nick Johnson putting on a show for the fans here in Honolulu.
Well, when your dad is known as Jumpin' Joey Johnson and had a 52-inch vertical for the ASU Sun Devils, some of those genes are going to fall down your way. And Nick Johnson, one of the best athletes in all of America, hashtag SC Top 10 nominee. This has to be on there for sure. One of the best dunks so far in college basketball.
You'll get no argument from me. Brilliant play and the steal and the slam by Nick Johnson. Brandon Ashley leads Arizona with 9, but Nick Johnson's kind of the do-everything guy for Sean Miller's Arizona Wildcats this season. One of two players in the country that's averaging 13 points, 3 assists, and 3 steals a game, along with Kevin Foster of Santa Clara. They're the only two in the country. Jordan Mays into the ballgame for Arizona. 6'3 junior from Los Angeles.
East Tennessee State doing a great job of being active. That was their best possession on the zone, closing out to three-point shooters, not letting the ball get into the high post area.
This is where the Buccaneers have struggled, though. They're 3 of 11 from the field and have turned the ball over 5 times.
Well, what Arizona does defensively, they like to put a lot of pressure on the basketball, and then they play pack line defense, taking away driving lanes and passing lanes and trying to make you a contested two-point shooting team.
Brandon Ashley loses it out of bounds. It stays with East Tennessee State. The Buccaneers have not scored from the floor in about 4 minutes. There's a 3 from the corner. That one spins out from Mario Stramaglia. And here comes Arizona. Solomon Hill short on a 3. Loose ball. Corralled by East Tennessee State and Jarvis Jones.
East Tennessee State just not able to get anything in transition. Even on the long rebounds, Ashley able to get his hand on that basketball, and that allows the Wildcats to get back and stop any break opportunity that the Bucks may have.
Hunter Harris inside, misses the shot at the rim, and Arizona comes away with it. Solomon Hill, a deep 3. And East Tennessee State clears, limiting Arizona to 1-and-done again.
Wilson has to look to be aggressive, trying to get to the lane, maybe get to the foul line, try to draw some fouls against Solomon Hill, just to get himself in a rhythm.
Shot clock at 10. And another turnover by the Buccaneers. Mark Lyons spinning into the front court. Saved. But Arizona gets it right back.
And Lyons may have done a little bit too much on that play. I thought he could have gave it up a little bit earlier. And then he put Nick Johnson in a tough position trying to catch that lob.
Mark Lyons missing the three, and the rebound, Lester Wilson for East Tennessee State. East Tennessee State has had their difficulties in the offensive end so far this year. Is only three times this year they have reached the 60-point barrier.
Well, you have to remember, this is really a depleted roster for East Tennessee State. Sheldon Cooley, Marcus DeBose were dismissed from the team. Petey McClain is on the bench with an ankle injury. He would be the starting point guard right now with this current roster. And Lucas Pedaris has a torn Achilles, another guy that would be their starting center. So they're really playing shorthanded right now in December.
Turnover by Arizona, and Murray Bardo's team just 2-7, having lost four straight. Successful coach, also 6 years at Alabama Birmingham. 284 wins for his career. And he's had a number of 21 seasons, seven in fact, so he's done a nice job at a proud program at East Tennessee State, but this has the makings of a rough season for the Buccaneers.
Well, he's been very successful. They've gone to the NCAAs in 2009 and 2010. They go to the postseason last year, the semifinals of the College Insider Tournament.
There's a three too strong from Rashawn Rembert. Arizona clears, but a foul first against Arizona. Well, East Tennessee State hasn't always had difficulty scoring. They called him Mr. Keith Mr. Jennings could light it up for East Tennessee State. That's a beautiful look over the Pacific from the infinity pool at the Sheraton Waikiki, hosting the cast and crew for this Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic. Was sitting out there earlier. Great experience just sitting out at Waikiki Beach. Aren't many better places to be in all the world than right here.
I can't complain. Right now, celebrating Christmas time in Hawaii. One of the most, you're truly in a tropical paradise.
25-8, Arizona leading East Tennessee State. And speaking of East Tennessee State, one of the greatest players in Buccaneers history. They called him Mr. Keith Jennings, was an outstanding player for East Tennessee State.
At 5'7", could do it all for East Tennessee State Bucks. Get to the rim, shoot the jump shots. But the thing that I noticed the most about those pictures, how about the tights coming down, coming down to the knees, the shorts still showing about 2 inches of the tights. Uniforms have come a long ways since the days of Mr. Jennings.
Mr. Jennings, fourth in Buccaneers history in scoring. And Greg Dennis also played with Mr. Jennings on those teams, but it was an outstanding big man. 25-8, Arizona, East Tennessee State. trying to get some semblance of a rhythm going offensively here.
And now Arizona going with their small lineup. This is Solomon Hill at the four spot, a position he had to play a lot last year because of lack of height, lack of depth at the post position for the Wildcats.
Second bucket for Jarvis Jones. And it creeps the Buccaneers within 15. Again, East Tennessee State going with the zone defense.
Now watch for them with big emphasis getting that ball to high post to Parham.
Kick out to Mark Lyons. And it goes out of bounds off the Buccaneers. It will stay with Arizona. And the last time these two teams squared off, you have to go back to 1992 in the first round of the NCAA tournament. And the second-seeded Arizona Wildcats beaten by East Tennessee State. Deep three rattles out for Mark Lyons and cleared by Rashawn Rembert in East Tennessee State.
And Wildcat fans don't want to be reminded of that. I experienced one of our Arizona first-round flameouts in 90, my freshman year, 94-95. We lose to Miami of Ohio. Not a fun experience getting knocked out in the first round of the NCAA tournament.
Fallon Nick Johnson, his first. That was a good Miami of Ohio team, though.
Devin Davis, he with the dreadlocks going back and forth. They really took it to us. We had a led by seniors, Damon Stoudemire, Ray Owes. We had Reggie Geary, Corey Williams, some excellent Wildcat players, but they were ready for us that day.
As was East Tennessee State in 1992, ready for the Wildcats. They played earlier that season, actually, in the preseason NIT as Jarvis Jones off the mark.
And East Tennessee State in that game hits 11 three-pointers in the first half alone against Arizona to really get the lead and take control.
Nick Johnson fouled on his way to the basket. And the foul committed by John Walton of East Tennessee State, his second already. Third team foul committed by the Buccaneers, and Nick Johnson, a 73% foul shooter, at the line to shoot a pair here.
And Coach Miller really, he couldn't have any more praise for Nick Johnson and his growth as a player last year. Just had so much thrown at him as a freshman. With the multiple suspensions of Josiah Turner, Nick Johnson having to play starting point guard sometimes, backup point guard sometimes, just didn't know exactly where he was going to fit in. It was an adjustment defensively for him throughout the year, and now you just see a great confidence level and comfortability level out there on the floor, and the numbers are showing that.
One more shot coming for Nick Johnson. Cabe York at the scorer's table getting set to check in for Sean Miller. And Johnson hits both. And the first look at Cabe York for Arizona. Next Saturday, December 29th, the two top programs in women's college basketball go head-to-head as Gino Auriemma leads the Huskies against Tara Vanderveer's top-ranked Cardinal. UConn-Stanford next Saturday at 4 on ESPNU and also live on Watch ESPN. ESPN, the home court of college hoops.
UConn with Kalina Mosqueda Lewis, a modern-day high school graduate who was a National High School Player of the Year, leading the way for the Huskies.
Uniobar Ueta with a three for East Tennessee State.
And that's really a weakness of Arizona defensively. The last couple years, they've been number one and number three in the country in three-point field goal percentage defense. This year, giving up 38% from the three-point line. One of the few weaknesses of the Wildcats defense.
What can you do if you're Arizona to improve that?
Well, they just keep working on it daily in practice, and there, Brandon Ashley with the short closeout didn't really get to the shooter. But it's something Coach Miller really emphasizes. They want to take away the three-point shot as best as possible, not doing it as well this season to this point.
Kevin Parham goes inside, gets his own miss. Stripped, gets it back, and gets a little testy there between Kevin Parham and John Walton of East Tennessee State. Don't think they were necessarily exchanging holiday pleasantries right there. Kevin Parham getting tangled up with John Walton there, and the foul called against Walton.
Kevin Parham just trying to be strong on the inside, misses the first chippy, gets that elbow raised up, and then trying to just protect that basketball.
Actually, Lester Wilson called for the foul, his first, and the fourth on the Buccaneers. Three freshmen on the floor right now for the Wildcats with two seniors.
And Gabe York getting some early playing time here in the first half. A young man that Coach Sean Miller said is improving every day, needs to be a little bit better defensively, but came in with a great reputation as a scorer out of Orange Lutheran High School in California.
Rashawn Rembert goes inside, swatted away by Grant Jarrett.
And as we speak about his defense, he gets beat too easily to the baseline, has to slide over and cut that off.
Mark Lyons rims off a three, and the rebound, John Walton of East Tennessee State, and a foul against the Wildcats.
You see York, the freshman, gets beat on the baseline, but Grant Jarrett using that tremendous wingspan, 7 feet, 2 inch wingspan, second longest on the team, to just go up, time that, and keep that basketball in bounds, more importantly, on the block.
Jarrett also called for the last foul, his first. And for Arizona, that's their fourth team foul. But another turnover by East Tennessee State.
And for the Bucks, that's just too long of a pass. You're 25 to 30 feet apart against a good defensive team. You got to shorten your passing angles and your passing distance to make it easier.
Jordan Mays in the game for Arizona. A little trap now employed by East Tennessee State. Gabe York, the off-balance runner, tipped up and in for the weak side by Grant Jarrett.
Good job of anticipating on the offensive rebound by Grant Jarrett and nice, the soft putback.
Arizona has led by as many as 17 already in this first half. And a foul called against Arizona, and East Tennessee State will get a couple of free throws. The Arizona Wildcats in the quarterfinals of the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic up big.
ESPNU's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by K Jewelers. Every kiss begins with K. And Gildan. We make your favorite activewear, underwear, and socks. Gildan, every thread counts.
All right, Matt, 3:46 remaining first half here in Honolulu. As the Arizona Wildcats right now ranked number 4, up 29-13 here on East Tennessee State, but they'll have a chance to move up, Miles, with Syracuse's loss earlier today.
Yeah, Syracuse losing to Temple today in the Garden. But how about a top 10 matchup earlier today? Kansas going on the road to beat Ohio State. Kansas loses Thomas Robinson and Tyshawn Taylor, really two guys that carried them to the national title game last year. But Jeff Withey, Ben McLemore. Jeff Withey's going to be an All-American by the end of the season. Ben McLemore, one of the best freshmen in the country right now, had the red shirt last season.
First shot knocked in by Jarvis Jones, who's now 1 of 2 at the line this season. and he has 5 points to lead the Buccaneers. Jones, a senior from Memphis, hitting both. Started now the last 3 games. He was academically ineligible for the first 7 this year for East Tennessee State. The dominance you were talking about, Miles, inside for Arizona.
Well, they're just so much bigger and more athletic in the inside, something that Sean Miller has not had a luxury of having in his time as the Arizona Wildcat coach, but now having Angelo Troll, Grant Jarrett, Caleb Karczewski, and Brandon Ashley on the inside gives Sean Miller more firepower to play with, and they're really taking advantage tonight on the inside.
Arizona was threatening to run away from East Tennessee State and blow them out here in the first half, but East Tennessee State has kind of weathered the storm a little bit. They're hanging in there. If they can get it to maybe 10 miles by halftime, they're going to feel pretty good about the way they're going into the locker room.
Yeah, they've turned the ball over 8 times in the first half, but they're really trying to control the pace and keep it a half-court game and not let Arizona get out in transition.
There is a 3 well off the mark from Jarvis Jones. Kevin Parham lines up a 3 and hits it from the top.
And what a special story Kevin Parham is. Last fall, suffers a gunshot wound to his right leg. Lost his grandmother and his mother within a couple months span. His mother dying of breast cancer. And he, not only physically, but emotionally tough year for that young man. Has really bounced back strong and one of the best glue guys in the country for the Arizona Wildcats and Sean Miller.
And Kevin Parham just hitting that 3, the senior from the Bronx, who won the Wilma Rudolph Award for perseverance and success last season, and now in his senior season, really playing well as the 6th man for the Arizona Wildcats.
Well, he's putting up great numbers. He's what you call a 180 guy. That means he's shooting 50% from the field, 40% from the line, and 90 from the free throw line. That's 40% from the 3-point line. Great drive and kick out to Nick Johnson for the 3. But only 5 NBA players ever have been a 180 guy. And that's Steve Nash, Larry Bird, Mark Price, Dirk Nowitzki, and Reggie Miller. And Kevin Parham doing that right now for the Wildcats.
Arizona's largest lead with 1:46 remaining here in this first half.
And Arizona with excellent ball movement. They get a paint touch there, then another paint touch and a kick out. Nick Johnson ready to shoot. Beautiful arc. Holds that follow through, knocks it down from the 3.
Sean Miller's ball club just when East Tennessee State was threatening to hang in this game, where the Wildcats have put some distance between themselves and East Tennessee State here late in the first half.
Well, Arizona's been a team that's known for going on huge runs this season. They can get stops, and then they have great, as they would say, spurtability, and they can score and they can score in bunches. And really, that's how they won the game against Florida a week ago. The last 2 minutes of each half, going on huge runs to win that basketball game.
Solomon Hill powers his way inside, blocked from behind, but a foul against Unio Barrueta of East Tennessee State. His first and a couple of free throws for the Arizona senior, Solomon Hill.
And when you're operating in the high post area, Solomon Hill did a great job there. We freeze it here. He squares up, sees what's going on, then he sees that he can attack one-on-one against Hunter Harris, goes up strong, some of the versatility that the 6'8 Solomon Hill has. The senior from Fairfax High School in Los Angeles, California.
This is the first, one more coming. Is Solomon Hill, an interesting story. Originally committed to Arizona in high school when Lute Olson was still the coach, but then decommitted, pledged to USC, and then came back to Arizona and signed with Sean Miller.
Well, when Tim Floyd was let go or resigned from USC, then that opened it up, and Sean Miller was really the benefactor of Tim Floyd leaving USC, because they get Momo Jones, who helped lead them to the Elite Eight 2 years ago. They get Derek Williams out of that, who was really an underrated recruit. Tim Floyd recognized his talent from LA. And then Solomon Hill, you throw him in that group, and you have a heck of a recruiting class for Sean Miller. And you just see the improvement year to year for Solomon Hill. Great stat on the player development that Sean Miller has been excellent at through his time as a head coach. Solomon Hill made 4 threes when he was a freshman. This year he's on pace to make 54. Has really worked on his shooting, has a great regimen every day during practice and during the offseason, just improving his 3-point shot.
Solomon Hill coming off a strong game against Oral Roberts on Tuesday night, the last outing for Arizona, and a decisive win at McHale Center in Tucson, and six steals in that game for Solomon Hill in that win against Oral Roberts. Arizona in that ball game. Mark Lyons led five players in double figures. He had 17. Arizona shot 58% from the field against Oral Roberts on Tuesday night. Arizona leading by 21.
And Arizona back to the smaller lineup. Solomon Hill playing the four spot. Excellent job by Nick Johnson fronting that post. And then Solomon Hill with the backside help.
Tie up, alternating possession. It'll stay with East Tennessee State.
This is a great lineup for Arizona because Solomon Hill is definitely comfortable at the four spot. He has the size and strength to guard any four man in the country. Did a great job on Eric Murphy late in the game in the win against Florida a week ago.
Jarvis Jones with the bucket for East Tennessee State.
Jarvis Jones, a great scorer for the Bucks. He actually scored 50 points in a high school game before. Hasn't shot the ball well in his two games during the season. And then the beautiful finish there now by Caleb Tarzewski, the seven-footer, Arizona, showing all their weapons in the first half.
And the great passing on the interior by Arizona. That easy slam by the seven-footer, Tarzewski. Three no good from Hunter Harris, and Arizona clears, and the Wildcats can play for the final shot of the first half. And a block is called as Mark Lyons trying to go into the key in the block against Rashawn Remper.
And here's the setup against the zone. Nick Johnson, beautiful. Two bounce passes through the interior. You remember, zone defenses, you're always taught to keep your hands up and be active. So he pass fakes high, throws low. Solomon Hill sees his buddy with the great peripheral vision and the beautiful finish from Caleb Tarzewski.
7.3 seconds remaining in the half. It was the sixth East Tennessee State team foul, so not a shooting foul. Arizona on the next one will be in the bonus. Nick Johnson, a kick out. Mark Lyons from the corner. And that will do it for the first half as the Arizona Wildcats with a 21-point lead on East Tennessee State here in Honolulu.
Great job of coming out with energy and effort by the Arizona Wildcats. Nick Johnson with the highlight reel dunk, got him going early. Wildcats big at the half.
Start the clock. We start with the layup, and then we work our way down. So, Good luck to Sam. On your mark, get set, and go. 45 seconds on the clock. It's the layout.
You are watching the 2012 Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic in Honolulu, Hawaii. Due to time constraints, we move ahead in our action. You're watching the 2012 Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic from Honolulu, Hawaii. We'll get you back to action after these messages. It's halftime in Honolulu, Hawaii at the 2012 Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic. ESPN College Basketball is available live anytime, anywhere on your computer, tablet, or smartphone at watchespn.com and with the Watch ESPN app. We'll get you back to the action after these messages.
You're watching ESPN's Holiday Hoops, presented by Kay Jewelers. You're watching ESPN's Holiday Hoops, presented by Kay Jewelers.
Thank you.
You're watching ESPN's Holiday Hoops, presented by Kay Jewelers.
Watching the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic, all part of Holiday Hoops, presented by K Jewelers. We're fourth-ranked Arizona, a big 38-17 on East Tennessee State. In the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic, Indiana State and 18th-ranked San Diego State have already advanced, and Arizona trying to punch their ticket into the semifinals and trying to finish off East Tennessee State. Along with Miles Simon, Roxy Bernstein with you from Honolulu, where the Arizona Wildcats are playing like the fourth-ranked team in the country, dominant in the first half, especially inside.
Well, they really came out with a lot of energy and passion in the first half. They jumped on East Tennessee State, and they did it with points in the paint, where they have a distinct height and size advantage on the inside. The three freshmen in Jared, Ashley, and Tarzewski, a combined 19 points on 9 of 12 field goals, many of those coming via interior passes on the inside, offensive boards. 8 of them in the first half for the Wildcats, dominating inside of the paint.
Take a look at the numbers from the first half as Arizona started the game by scoring the first 11 points in this one. And the points in the paint, 18-2. And a significant advantage in Arizona capitalizing on that.
And that's 17 points for East Tennessee State, a Diamond Head Classic record for fewest points in a first half, previously held by USC in 2009 of 18.
So a 21-point lead for the Wildcats. Going on a lob immediately as we start the second half, and Brandon Ashley is fouled at the rim.
And you love to see a team come out and execute the drawn-up play out of the halftime locker room for the lob for Brandon Ashley, forcing the Bucks to foul, or so it was going to be a slam dunk.
Brandon Ashley shooting two shots, 1 of 1 at the line in this one, 73% on the year. And Ashley, first player on either side in double figures with 10.
And Brandon Ashley had a game back in November against Long Beach State where he went for 20 and 10. The only freshman in the last 10 years in Arizona Wildcats history to do that were Chase Budinger and Derek Williams.
It's pretty good company he's in.
Two pretty good players right there.
So 23-point lead for the Wildcats, their largest of the game.
What Sean Miller has to be happy with coming out of that halftime locker room, looking at one stat, defending the three-point line. East Tennessee State goes 2 for 13. They've done an excellent job of closing out the shooters and make everything contested.
Jarvis Jones, the runner, banks it in.
Jones has done a nice job of scoring the basketball, and that's now his 10th point of the game. Has to do a better job of taking care of it as he had 5 turnovers in the first half.
Inside with the left hand, Brandon Ashley again for the Wildcats.
Arizona's such an unselfish team. Tarzewski probably could have laid that up, shot a baby jump hook from 3 or 4 feet, but he gave it to an easier shot for his teammate, Brandon Ashley.
So many weapons with his Arizona team, so versatile. It seems like on any night, a different player could lead this team in scoring.
It's something that Sean Miller hasn't had in his time as the Arizona Wildcat coach. And I know they went to the Elite Eight 2 years ago, but that was largely in part to Derek Williams having a National Player of the Year type season. This year, more versatility, more depth, more balance for the Wildcats.
Stripped and stolen by East Tennessee State. Here comes Rashawn Rembert. Nice move, but Jarvis Jones cannot finish, and then called for the reach-in foul, his second.
And Brandon Ashley, good interior pass. And look at Tarzewski, doesn't even come down with the basketball. Makes the touch pass to the diving Brandon Ashley, who kept that ball up high and finished at the front of the rim.
Arizona looking for their first 10-0 start since they began the 87-88 season, 12-0. And one of 5 remaining teams in college basketball, unbeaten.
And there's one of the very few mistakes that Arizona has made today. Nick Johnson, usually an excellent passer, has an over 2-to-1 assist to turnover ratio this year. Throws that basketball behind Tarzewski.
Sean Rembert.
Arizona just taking the Bucks out of all their first and second option looks and making them play one-on-one. Solomon Hill with the steal.
Arizona attacks. And a foul and a clear out called underneath against East Tennessee State. And the third foul against John Walton of the Buccaneers. And the third team foul against ETSU here in the second half.
And this is all really Walton could do as the seven-footer Tarzewski was getting in position for that offensive rebound. John Walton with the push-off.
Nick Johnson short on a three. And East Tennessee State looks to break out. Brandon Ashley controls the defensive glass for Arizona. Only ranked team in the Pac-12 conference are these Arizona Wildcats.
And the Pac-12 has done better this year. Let's remember last season in the Pac-12. The conference as a whole didn't beat a ranked team. Okay, this year, good early season win. Colorado beats Baylor when Baylor was in the top 20. Oregon goes on the road, wins at Thomson Mac against a very good UNLV team that still had Mike Moser in the lineup at the time. UCLA, a team that was hoping to come back to prominence this year, has struggled, losses to Cal Poly.
But their Texas win is looking better as the Longhorns with the big win against North Carolina the other night.
Yeah, then Texas loses at Michigan State today. Obviously, not an easy place to play. But Arizona, really, the class of the conference right now, if I had to rank it, I would say Oregon is maybe the second best team. I know they suffered a triple overtime loss at UTEP. Colorado, still a good team with Robertson, Josh Scott, Spencer Dinwiddie's having a great season.
Oregon State's playing pretty well also.
Ahmad Stark's doing well there.
Jarvis Jones knocks in the free throw as Oregon State with a win over Purdue.
Stanford beats at Northwestern. You know, had a tough loss, bounce back win after losing at NC State. Cal really had a chance, I thought, to be an excellent team. Now the season is still young, but they hosted two ranked teams within a week. Lose on a putback against UNLV, and then Doug McDermott comes in and goes to work.
Put up a season high 34
against the Cal Bears, and they really needed to win at least one of those two games, if not both, and they probably would have been ranked at this time.
And the foul on the offensive charge by Mark Lyons, his third personal foul. And the Wildcats lead it by 21, but the giveaway.
And Lyons just out of control. You got to stop and pop from about 10 feet right there. He wanted to get all the way to the rim. Excellent job by Hunter Harris of taking the charge.
And the block shot, but a foul. And Mark Lyons called for his fourth. So with 16:20 remaining, Arizona up by 21. Mark Lyons called for his fourth personal foul.
And here Lyons just trying to recover and clean up top, but body contact down low by Mark Lyons. He still can't believe the call, but the replay evidence shows that it was a foul.
Jarvis Jones rolls the free throw in. He's now 5 of 5 at the line. And leads East Tennessee State with 12 points as Lyons will check out with the four personal fouls.
And Mark Lyons, the transfer from Xavier, eligible right away because of the graduation rule. He finished his time at Xavier, graduated already. You can enroll at another university without having to sit out a year if they have a graduation major that is not at your previous school.
And a foul to pass committed by East Tennessee State. And Hunter Harris, his third personal foul.
Arizona not looking as sharp in this first 4 minutes of the second half. Sometimes when you have such a big lead at the half, you tend to have a letdown in spurts in the second half, but Coach Tom Miller, you don't want to see that, especially because you're going to have to play back-to-back nights.
Over and back violation called against Arizona is the officials. And Don Daly, who's the lead official, working with Randy Heimerman and Winston Stith, called the over and back call as according to the officials. Jordan Mays never established himself back in the front court after slipping into the backcourt.
And Jordan Mays was anticipating there was going to be a turnover, and he was not established. He had not established his 2 feet back in the front court before he caught that basketball.
Inside to John Walton. The basket. Miss. Kayla Tarzewski the rebound and a hard fall to the deck. And a foul against East Tennessee State.
And you see the struggles continue for East Tennessee State, just having trouble finishing around the size of this Arizona Wildcats, down 19 in the second half.
Look at the
by K Jewelers. Every kiss begins with K. And DirecTV. Don't just watch TV, DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
Infinity pool at the Sheraton Waikiki. Speaking of Sheraton, the Sheraton Hawaii Bowl coming up on Monday at Christmas Eve, 8 p.m. Eastern. Fresno State and SMU and June Jones return to the islands. Your first trip over here for the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic.
It is, and I'm really enjoying myself. It's beautiful, picturesque landscape out there. The beach is awesome. The water's warm. The sun is shining.
What else do you want?
Can't ask for anything better in late December. And you get to enjoy some hoops.
Exactly. And the highest-ranked team to ever participate in the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic, fourth-ranked Arizona, up 42-23.
And you see Sean Miller right now with his hand on his forehead, scratching his head. He totally a tale of two halves right now. That's already the fifth turnover in the second half for the Wildcats, just not playing sharp basketball. And you don't want to have that, you know, bad feeling leaving this game. They need to pick it up, play sharp, as they'll play back-to-back nights here in the Diamond Head.
Regardless of the outcome, and if Arizona comes away with a big win over East Tennessee State, as Lester Wilson hits the three, his second triple.
And that's really,
and it's down to 16.
And that's really the strength of Lester Wilson's game. I like the adjustment, the roll and replace action. They put Lester Wilson at the four, bringing him up to the three-point line to knock that down.
But even if you win big, Miles, and if you're Arizona, is this a type of game that can frustrate a coach in Sean Miller?
I mean, it can frustrate if you guys aren't doing the things not that you're asking them to do, like execution, like that being their sixth turnover in less than 6 minutes in the second half. And he's letting them play through it, and they got to work through these pains right now in the second half, but they really got to pick up their level of play.
Jarvis Jones on the drive, hits the runner.
And then now a poor job on the defensive end. Caleb Tarzewski not shutting off the drive. Jordan Mays not getting back in front. Jarvis Jones making him play, and now it's a 14-point game, and you're letting East Tennessee State hang around. This is the letdown that you can have after you're up by 21 at halftime.
And the lead has been as large as 23, but East Tennessee State has scored 9 straight. Grant Jarrett missing the three. East Tennessee State in Unio Barrueta with the rebound. Tough step back. Short from Rashawn Rembert. The rebound, Grant Jarrett, fuels the Arizona break.
East Tennessee State doing a better job in the second half of limiting transition. But part of that comes with they've been scoring some baskets in the second half, making Arizona take it out of the net.
Nice pass from Kevin Parham to Caleb Tarzewski.
Third time we've seen that tonight. They get that ball in the mid-post area. They put one of their small forwards, Solomon Hill or Kevin Parham, as the high post passer, and Tarzewski with the monster finish.
Off-balance runner, pretty move by Jarvis Jones.
Jarvis Jones playing in only his third game, had academic issues, was suspended for the first semester. Big-time score for the Bucks.
Minutes remaining, Arizona by 14.
And we see Kevin Parham usually at the high post with this lineup in with Grant Jarrett. That's by design.
Solomon Hill hustling back. Last touch by a diving Rashawn Rembert. And it goes right back to Arizona. If the Wildcats gave it away, East Tennessee hands it over right back to the Wildcats.
And if we freeze it right here, we see Kevin Parham is in the high post area. This is Grant Jarrett, the four-man out on the perimeter, makes the great interior pass. Hunter Harris has to step up, and Tarzewski is more than a mismatch for Barrueta on the backside of the zone.
He's more of a mismatch than just for just about everybody in college basketball. Solomon Hill short of three, but Kevin Parham there to clean it up.
Parham just being active around the glass, anticipating the miss, and cleans up the garbage and puts it away.
Jarvis Jones missing, but here's a three from Lester Wilson. That's another brick, and here come the Wildcats. Solomon Hill, count it and one for the senior Solomon Hill.
Solomon Hill just too strong, too fast for the East Tennessee State Bucks. Long shots equal long rebounds. And the best thing you love as a coach is when your guards or forwards can handle the ball in transition after a rebound. That starts your break quicker than anything you can do if a big gets the rebound and has to outlet it. And Solomon Hill, one of the most versatile guys in the country.
So for the plus one free throw, Hill one of two at the line in this one. Third foul on Jarvis Jones. Arizona already in the bonus. The seventh team foul committed by East Tennessee State.
Solomon Hill is a guy I got to spend a lot of time around this summer, working the Nike Skills Academies, the Kevin Durant camp, the LeBron James camp, where he showed very well against some of the more elite forwards in the country, Elias Harris, CJ McCollum, Rodney Magruder, CJ Leslie, Otto Porter. Solomon Hill drawing high praise from some of the NBA scouts that were there.
There is the bracket for the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic. Indiana State outlasting Ole Miss in overtime. Jake Odom and the Sycamores onto the semis. We'll play Chase Tapley in 18th ranked San Diego State. One semifinal here tomorrow. The winner of this matchup will go on to the semifinals and take on the winner of the nightcap here at the Stan Sheriff Center in Honolulu. The host, Hawaii Rainbow Warriors and the Miami Hurricanes. Grant Jarrett missing a three, but the follow by Kevin Parham.
I love what Kevin Parham's doing on that possession. Makes himself available in the high post. Looks outside right away to the three-point shooter, Jarrett, and doesn't give up on the play. Gets the tip in at the buzzer, and the beautiful sunset here at the Diamond Head Classic in Hawaii as Arizona leading by 21.
Well, Kevin is the ultimate survivor. You know, he was shot. He was shot while visiting his mom, who passed away about a month after he was shot. His grandmother passed away earlier in the summer. He just overcome those three things, and he's had a number of setbacks. If you can imagine, after overcoming all that, he breaks his foot, misses really the last third of the season. Well, Kevin is the
Arizona Wildcats leading East Tennessee State 51-30, 11:40 remaining here in the quarterfinal matchup of the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic. And Kevin Parham having a big evening for the Arizona Wildcats, one of the real key contributors for Sean Miller.
Well, Kevin is the ultimate survivor. You know, he was shot. He was shot while visiting his mom, who passed away about a month after he was shot. His grandmother passed away earlier in the summer. He just overcome those three things, and he's had a number of setbacks. If you can imagine, after overcoming all that, he breaks his foot. This is really the last third of the season.
And Kevin Parham with 7 points for Arizona, really remarkable story. And it's amazing that Kevin Parham is able to play as well as he has, considering everything he's been through. And it was very easy for him to give it all up, Miles, after what he went through last year. Could have just walked away and said, I'm done with this. But he has fought through the adversity that he's had to deal with, and it's paying dividends, not just for him, but for his teammates as well.
And he was a guy that was really sorely missed in this Arizona lineup last year, not because of his numbers, but because of his toughness. Sean Miller had called him the heart and soul of
leadership.
This team. And this Arizona team last year went through some turbulent times. Josiah Turner, the highly ranked point guard, multiple suspensions, ended up leaving the program, turning pro now. But Parham, a guy that could have helped this team. They lost in the first round of the NIT at home to Bucknell last year as Jarvis Jones knocks down the deep three and gets fouled. Excellent job by East Tennessee State. Using the pick and roll, extra pass. Knocked down three by Lester Wilson. East Tennessee State and Jarvis Jones trying to hang in there with Arizona. The fourth-ranked Wildcats lead
the Buccaneers, 51-33. But Jones with 17 points and one all a career high already for the senior from Memphis, Tennessee.
Yeah, the redshirt senior, the only one on the roster, has really had to create a lot of it on his own. He has 18 of the Bucs' 33 points. He's an elite scorer, can score inside and out, and struggle from the three-point line. But really, had early in the second half, kept the Bucs within striking distance. Arizona stretched it out a little bit. Jones playing in only his third game of the season for Murray Bartow and the East Tennessee State Bucs.
The free throw for the rare four-point play opportunity rims off for Lester Wilson. Arizona with the ball as Jones also at 18 points last season in a game against Lipscomb. And now let's match that here with Arizona tonight in the opening round of the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic in Honolulu. Grant Jarrett from the corner. Kept alive. And a foul against East Tennessee State will send Brandon Ashley to the foul line. 18th foul on the Buccaneers.
And again, just that interior pass to get the ball into the high post to Parham collapses the defense of the Bucs. Everybody focused on the ball at the high post. Grant Jarrett spotting up, just not able to knock down the threes tonight. He's 47% on the season going into this game. But Brandon Ashley staying active on the glass, keeping that ball high, going to the line.
Ashley leads Arizona with 14. Foul against Hunter Harris of East Tennessee State, his fourth. So he has four. John Walton has four for East Tennessee State. And we still have a little bit over 10 minutes remaining here to play. The winner advances to the semis to meet the winner of Hawaii and Miami tomorrow night here in Honolulu. And a foul trying to split the double team as Jarvis Jones taken down. And the second on Brandon Ashley of Arizona.
Nice job by Jarvis Jones going to his weak hand. He's a lefty, gets tripped up by the Wildcats on defense. Jones having to really do everything because so many of the other Bucs players struggling to score from the field. Jarvis Jones has made 6 of their 11 field goals.
Not just struggling in this one tonight, but it's been a struggle for Murray Bartow's team all season long. It's Jarvis Jones coming over to the side to talk to his coach, but the injuries that they've been through without Petey McLean tonight, he's out with the ankle injury. Lucas Pederis lost for the season with an Achilles tear and a scrimmage even before the season began, and then had the unfortunate circumstances surrounding the dismissal of Sheldon Cooley and Marcus Dubose after a couple of games into the season for East Tennessee State. As they were kicked off the team for a violation of team rules and policies, and was not a difficult decision for Murray Bartow to make to get rid of those two. East Tennessee State, everything they've been through, a team that won 17 games a year ago, but have really struggled offensively. When you take Pederis away, you take Dubose and Cooley off this roster, those were guys that they were counting on to be key contributors for this team that lost three seniors from a year ago that combined to score more than 3,000 points.
And despite all that, in talking to Coach Bartow yesterday, they feel that they still have a chance to compete and win the Atlantic Sun Conference. Mercer, who's favored to win the league this season, knocked off Alabama on the road today. So Mercer's obviously a very good team, but he feels even as young as their roster is, they can get Petey McLean back after the ankle injury. Once he's healthy, adds a little bit more depth, especially at the guard spot, will allow Jarvis Jones to move off the ball. They'll have two great wing scorers. Lester Wilson will be a dominant player in the A-Sun. He's big, he's strong, he's athletic. He hasn't scored the ball as well today as he has throughout the season. But Coach Bardo's teams, they know how to compete and battle. He's been to the NCAA tournament in 2009 and 2010, postseason last year in the College Insider tournament. Let's go,
get a stop. Hunter Harris has fouled out, scoreless tonight for East Tennessee State. 54-33, Arizona leads, and Ashley leads the Wildcats with 16 now. There's a three that rattles out from Lester Wilson. Here come the Wildcats. Nick Johnson on the go. Kick out, Grant Jarrett gets the three.
And that's some of Nick Johnson's versatility and where he's matured. Maybe last season he tries to take that all the way, draws a charge, but look at the composure and the timing that he brings that ball down under control, stops on the dime right inside the foul line and finds Grant Jarrett trailing the play for the three-point shot.
32nd timeout, East Tennessee State, as Arizona has their largest lead. Next Saturday, December 29th, the two top programs in women's college basketball go head-to-head as Gino Uriyama leads the Huskies against Tara Vanderveer's top-ranked Cardinal. It's UConn versus Stanford next Saturday at 4 on ESPNU and also live on Watch ESPN. ESPN, the home court of college hoops. The AP Women's Top 10. There's Stanford and UConn near the top. Brittany Griner and Baylor at number 3.
Is Brittany Griner arguably the most dominant player to ever play women's basketball? I think about Cheryl Miller, women's college basketball, Lisa Leslie, Diana Taurasi, Cheryl Swoops. But Brittany Griner right in that elite company there.
You have to put her right near the top. And I think you do have an argument if you want to make it that she has been the greatest player in women's college basketball. Rebecca Lobo. Brandon Ashley, the rebound is Arizona. Again, their largest lead, the fourth-ranked Wildcats. It is their highest ranking since they were number 3 back in January of 2004. Nick Johnson rattles out the pull-up. Angela Chole fouled on a putback.
Arizona's just been so dominant on the offensive glass tonight. That's now their 11th offensive rebound of the game. Angela Chole with his third. Just being active, anticipating misses, hanging around the glass. Tough time for the Bucks, blocking out in the zone.
First point tonight for Chole, is now 6 of 10 at the line this season. Angelo Chole, who's from San Diego, went to Hoover High School, but born in the Sudan, and became a naturalized U.S. citizen back in June of 2010. And he hits both free throws, and I'm really impressed with what I've seen from him so far, but it's just tough to crack the lineup when you have Caleb Tarzewski, Brandon Ashley, and Grant Jarrett on the same team as Angelo Chole.
And it's almost just a different story for Chole this year. He's almost having to relearn to play in the post position because last year he's only going against really Jesse Perry and Nat Yasko in the post. Now you have three really top 10 recruits that you're going against every day, but Chole continues to work. One of the best work ethics on the team, has really transformed his body, got more muscular, more athletic since he's arrived in Tucson.
Mark Lyons on the floor with his four fouls for Arizona. And a whistle off the ball and a 3-second violation in an Arizona turnover here to East Tennessee State.
And that was just Chole trying to work in the post there, trying to get position, battling for a post up, but just got caught with his feet in the paint too long.
So Angelo Chole, 6'9" sophomore from San Diego, really started to come on toward the end of last year, gaining confidence, really active on the defensive end, and very good shot blocker with good anticipation.
Well, he put up ridiculous numbers in high school, number 2 nationally all time in block shots, 1,120 in his high school career.
Off balance runner, no good from Kennard Gazdin-Gilliard for East Tennessee State. Here comes Mark Lyons. Jordan Mays long on the 3. East Tennessee State comes away with it. Pull up 3. Left-handed stroke. Jarvis Jones, a new career high of 21.
Not an easy shot for Jarvis Jones with the crossover stop and pop from deep right in the face of the Arizona defender.
So Jones has 21. The Buccaneers have 36 collectively. And a steal for East Tennessee State. Stramalia trying to go coast to coast, and he banks it in, driving to the hoop.
I still like what I'm seeing from this Bucks team. Just battling, scrapping.
They're playing hard.
Playing hard the whole game. Still active on the defensive end. Look at everybody's hands up. They're moving their feet. Not surrendering anything easy.
Illegal screen, offensive foul on Brandon Ashley. Arizona up big. Wildcats looking to go to 10-0. And possibly make a run to the championship. Somebody else knows something about bringing a championship to Tucson.
Local sports, because we're locals. We take pride. Congratulations to all the participating teams in the 2012 Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic.
All over here, he's hit us this day 20 times. 20 times. It's catch with two.
Two shots on both ends.
Ball. It's look at the guy. It's pounce pass when he's supposed to. Don't take
enjoy
it.
Free parking and come in this case when you dine at Rum Fun or Come Market at Sheraton Lake Keys. Call 921-4600 for more information.
Take care of the ball, play like a good team. Pounce pass, shot play. Pass play. Don't stand in 3 seconds. Hold to his set still.
Beautiful sunset over Waikiki. Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic is number 4 Arizona leading East Tennessee State. Trying to move to the semifinals, and Arizona Wildcats have dreams of winning a national championship, ranked number 4. And speaking of national championships, what was that?
Hey, when you're feeling it, playing in the dome in the Final Four national championship, I don't know, everything was going on. I was just excited, I guess.
That, of course, is my partner, Miles Simon, who led the Wildcats to the 1997 NCAA title as the only championship for Arizona. And Lute Olson, the most outstanding player from that Final Four, Miles Simon here. And what do you see from this Arizona team? Is just the big picture. Do they have an opportunity to bring a second championship to Tucson?
They have a chance to be a Final Four team. And if you get there, obviously anything goes in the Final Four. But I think they have a great balance of upperclassmen and underclassmen with the freshman post players that are going to get better 2 months from now. This will be a different Arizona team, a better Arizona team, as those freshmen really, I think they learned a lot going against the experienced front line of the Florida Gators last week, where Tarzewski, Jared, and Ashley only scored a combined 8 points, struggled a little bit against Murphy and Patrick Young and Will Yeget. But you love Mark Lyons at the point guard spot. He brings toughness. He's a big shot maker. Solomon Hill, one of the most versatile players in the country. And Nick Johnson, he's arguably the best player in the Pac-12 right now. I can't think of anyone playing better than Nick Johnson on a consistent basis.
Rebound cleared by John Walton. There's a lot of good players in the league, but yeah, you'd be hard-pressed to say somebody's playing better than Nick Johnson. Look at Andre Robertson at Colorado. Alan Crabb at Cal has played very well, although he struggled recently in a couple of ball games. Shabazz Muhammad starting to play better for UCLA.
Yeah, but you would arguably say maybe Jordan Adams has been the best freshman on that UCLA team. Jahi Carson's been excellent.
He's been terrific for Arizona State. Arizona by 21. They've led by as many as 26. Mark Lyons from long range gets the three.
And as we talk about national championships and getting to Final Fours, that young man right there, Mark Lyons, he's the whole key to this group. He's only been around the guys since the summertime, went on the trip to the Bahamas, so he's really still getting a feel of his teammates. This is only his 10th game in a Wildcat uniform. Obviously made a great impact last Saturday, hitting the game winner against the Florida Gators. But his teammates love him. They love his toughness. Sean Miller calls him his guttiest, grittiest player on the roster.
John Walton called for the charge, an offensive foul. He is fouled out of the game, but there's Miles' best teams out west. We could be destined for an Arizona-San Diego State finale here in Honolulu.
San Diego State's been great, only lost their first game of the year on the aircraft carrier to Syracuse. Gonzaga, they're deep, they're talented. Kevin Pangos, Elias Harris, Gary Bell, you can go on down the line. UNLV has been excellent. Mike Moser's out for an extended period of time with a dislocated elbow, but they get Kim Birch, the Pitt transfer. New Mexico, I know they slipped up today, but I've covered New Mexico in person. Steve Alford has a great team down there with Kendall Williams and Tony Snell. And you had Oregon, I think they're the second best team currently in the Pac-12. Lost in triple overtime at UTEP. Tim Floyd You know, he does a great job down there, hard to win there, but they did upset UNLV at the Thompson Mac. And there's Gabe York, the freshman, getting some playing time, getting his feet wet in this game. He's a guy that's going to be a great player down the line for the Arizona Wildcats. Hard to fit in the rotation this year with such depth at the guard spot for Arizona.
27-point lead for the Wildcats. Jordan Mays, 30-point game.
Jordan Mays for three.
And a timeout taken by East Tennessee State. 4:27 remaining, and Arizona has ballooned the lead out to 30 points, their largest of the game. And again, 4:27 left for Arizona to go to 10-0 and await the winner of Hawaii and Miami. ESPN College Basketball is available live anytime, anywhere, on your computer, tablet, or smartphone at watchespn.com and with the Watch ESPN app.
Use that today as
yes.
We were sitting poolside watching the plethora of games that were on ESPN2 today.
Switching back and forth between Illinois, Missouri on ESPN2, then over to ESPNU to watch the quarterfinal day session matchups here in Honolulu as Indiana State with the overtime win over Ole Miss and San Diego State, who was in a tight one with the USF Dons before the Aztecs pulled away late behind a career-high 33 from Chase Tapley. And now Arizona, East Tennessee State, and the Nightcap here in Honolulu will hit the hometown team. Rainbow Warriors of Hawaii against the U, Miami Hurricanes, right here on the U. There's a football legend at a couple of schools in this Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic. Dick Tomey, who coached over here and coached the Hawaii Warriors, but also was the mastermind behind the Desert Swarm defense.
The Desert Swarm, one of the greatest defenses. Teddy Bruschi leading the way for the Arizona Wildcats. Tomey, the head coach, went during my time as an Arizona Wildcat, 94 to 98.
There's a foul as Mario Stramaglia headed to the basket. We'll go to the free throw line here. Dick Tomey, legendary figure. As the coach, did an outstanding job here in Honolulu before moving over to Tucson and had a great run as the head coach of the Arizona Wildcats.
And as they show him on the big screen here, gets a great ovation from the crowd, Arizona and Hawaii crowd that's now filling in for the Nightcap.
The real fan favorite is Dick Tomey here in Honolulu. Now makes his home back over here in the islands.
Mario Stramaglia has been aggressive, playing well, broke his nose in their last game. So this is the first game that he's ever worn the mask, and it's a big difference wearing a mask. You know, some of your peripheral vision is taken away, you know, uncomfortability and having something on your head that you're not used to. But he's toughed it out today, played pretty well for the Bucks.
You ever wore one of those?
I have not. Luckily, I have kept my face pretty intact for the most part.
Final 4 minutes of this quarterfinal matchup. Gabe York off the mark on a three, and the rebound run down by Rashawn Rembert.
York already had it in his mind right there that he was going to shoot that. He should have shot fake, put that ball on the floor, and would have had a ton of decisions to make getting in the paint.
Nice move to the basket, but Unio Barueta can't finish. Arizona looks to counter, and a walk is called against Jordan Mays, and an Arizona turnover. Arizona pulling away from East Tennessee State, looking to go to 10-0 on the season.
ESPNU's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Hawaiian Airlines. Hawaii flies with us. And in part by Carfax. Just say, show me the Carfax. Ask your dealer or go to carfax.com.
Thank you. for basketball halftime during the Miami Hawaii game. Once again, the second desk is open. You can also sign up. You'll have time at the conclusion of this game.
Arizona in control of this one, leading East Tennessee State 68-40, along with Miles Simon. Roxy Bernstein with you. Game one of the night session here in Honolulu for the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic. And the finale here on this Saturday will be the home team, Hawaii, against Miami. As Kennard Gadsden-Gilliard gets on the scoreboard for the Buccaneers.
Nice job by Gadsden Gilliard, just penetrating, getting to the paint. Too easy.
Max Wheatking, a walk-on, a senior from Englewood, Colorado, comes off the bench for Sean Miller. And his team comfortably in front here with 3:07 to go. But coaches are always going to define something to nitpick about. Sean, what is something that Sean Miller is going to stress to his team they need to improve upon for tomorrow when they play either Hawaii or Miami?
Well, the biggest thing has been 11 turnovers in the second half, 17 for the game, and 9 of those turnovers in the game have been by their point guards, 4 by Lyons and 5 by Jordan Mays.
And Kennard Gadsden-Gilliard gets oohs and ahs from the crowd after that one.
Gadsden-Gilliard was a Tennessee Junior College National Player of the Year. He's a good ball handler, decent shooter. Gabe York gets caught up in the air. Now 12 turnovers in the second half by the Wildcats. Just haven't been as sharp. Gadsden-Gilliard, the big fella, taking the contact, able to throw that up over his head. Soft touch on the finish.
Crafty by the junior from Georgetown, South Carolina. Jarvis Jones, a career-high 21, but not enough for East Tennessee State. And Gadsden-Gilliard with 6, all coming here in the last minute and a half.
And that's a big man there. He's 6'5", 250, can play the perimeter. Coach Bardo said it's not unusual to see him running the break or even using pick and rolls, even though he's a post player.
Gabe York from the corner, second three for the freshman.
Beautiful skip pass to the corner for Gabe York, who had his feet set and ready to shoot.
Arizona has led by as many as 30 in this one. The Wildcats have hit 9 three-pointers. And coming up next from Honolulu, it'll be Rainbow Warriors of Hawaii hosting the Miami Hurricanes. Offensive rebound, Rashawn Rembert missing the putback. The rebound, Max Wheatking for Arizona. I'm looking forward to that game coming up next. I think we're in store for a good one between the U and Hawaii here on the U.
Yeah, Coach Jay Larinaga in his second season has done a great job. He has a lot of veterans. Shane Larkin running the point. Reggie Johnson down low. Duran Scott leads the way in scoring. But playing here against the University of Hawaii, they're going to have a nice crowd, near capacity. They have a big line of Christian Standardinger, one of the most underrated players in all of college basketball, at 27-10 at UNLV earlier this season.
There's the Hurricane players waiting. There's the Canes again taking on the Rainbow Warriors next. And a lot of size on both sides in this one. A big front line as Miami has 5 guys that are 6'10 or taller. And you mentioned Stan Hardinger for Hawaii, who has played well, but Vander Joachim has had a nice senior season so far for the Bows. So that's coming up next to round out quarterfinal action for the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic. As Jordan Mays hits the free throws. See, we're not the only guys that have the Aloha shirts ready. 73-46, Arizona leading. And a three knocked down by Rashawn Rembert, his first points on the night.
I really like what Jarvis Jones is showing tonight, ability to run the point. Obviously has had to score the ball a lot, but he really gets to that left hand.
Shot rattles off from Jacob Hazard, a freshman, a walk-on from LA. He went to Loyola High School. He is the grandson of former UCLA coach and legendary player Walt Hazard. So Jacob Hazard getting some time here late with Arizona comfortably in front. Foul, sending East Tennessee State to the line, and Yuno Mariota.
There's no quit in this Bucks team. Still attacking, still trying to score. Wildcats still need to do a better job defensively, getting stops here. Coach Miller will still point that out, even with those guys. He coaches everybody from the first to the 15th man.
First one knocked in. One more coming for Barrueta. Drew Mellon coming in, another walk-on for Arizona. Take a look at the Rainbow Warriors. Christian Stan Hardinger right there. In the front, the Nebraska transfer. He was playing very well for Gib Arnold and Hawaii. They're coming up next.
Hawaii, a team that took Illinois down to a last second shot, a three-pointer. Back in November before Illinois went on to the Maui Invitational.
Arizona leading by as many as 30. And the Wildcats going to 10-0 for the first time since 1987-88 when they began the year at 12-0. As the Wildcats, the number four ranked team in the country, remain unbeaten. And they knock off East Tennessee State 73-53.
Well, great effort early on from the Wildcats. They did the job that they needed to do by jumping on East Tennessee State. The starters got it going, built up a big lead and maintained it throughout the duration of the game.
That's put Arizona into the semifinals of the Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic, and the fourth ranked Cats will meet either Miami or Hawaii, which is coming up next from Honolulu. Indiana State, San Diego State, the other semifinal in this Hawaiian Airlines Diamond Head Classic. But a dominant performance from the Arizona Wildcats. Freshman Brandon Ashley leads the way with 16 as the outstanding freshmen from Arizona move on. And they'll take on again either Miami or Hawaii. They're coming up straight ahead. But coming up next, it's SportsCenter U with an update on four top 10 teams falling. Now let's send it to Matt Schick and the coach Dino Gaudio.
I don't like change now. It freaks me out.